Hello students, in this session we'll see a few basic problems on what integration. Okay, so let's see the first problem. Let's say integration of 3x raised to 4 dx. Okay, let's say we want to integrate it. Now how to integrate this? So integration of 3x raised to 4 dx equals to, I take 3 outside, it's a constant, I can take it outside, and inside we get x raised to 4 dx. And I have given the formula for integration of x raised to n dx. In the previous video I have given the formula. It's given by what? X raised to n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 plus some constant of integration c. Right, so if I use that formula, 3 as it is, if you compare these two, the value of n is here 4. So if you apply the formula, x raised to 4 plus 1 divided by 4 plus 1 plus constant of integration c. Right, this I write it as a reason. Now equals to 3, 4 plus 1 is 5. So 3 by 5, x raised to 4 plus 1 is 5. Plus constant of integration c. So integration of 3x raised to 4 dx is nothing but what? 3 by 5 x raised to 5 plus constant of integration c. We applied this formula, integration of x raised to n as what? X raised to n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 plus constant of integration c. Let's take one more example. Let's say integration of what? X raised to 3 or x cube plus 2x square plus 1. Let's say we want to integrate this. Okay, so how to do this? We have 3 different functions. You take 3 integrals for each of them. It is sum, right? So in that case, you can do one thing. You can take 3 integrals. Integral of x cube with respect to x plus integral of 2x square with respect to x plus integral of 1 with respect to x. Right, now equals to what is integration of x cube? Again you apply the same formula, integration of x raised to n plus 1 by n plus 1. So if I apply the formula, the value of n here is 3. X raised to 3 plus 1 divided by 3 plus 1 plus 2 outside, it's a constant. You apply integration of it, you find integration of x raised to 2, n value is 2 here. So if you apply the formula, x raised to 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 plus integration of 1 is nothing but x, integration of 1 is nothing but x plus some constant of integration c. Right, now equals to x raised to 3 plus 1 is 4. So x raised to 4 by 4 plus 2, 2 plus 1 is 3, 2 by 3, x raised to 2 plus 1 is 3 plus x plus constant of integration c. So here integration of x cube plus 2x square plus 1 dx. Okay, so this is the integration of this. Now you may ask, here we have 3 integrations, we should get 3 c's here. For this integration 1 c, for this integration 1 constant, for this integration 1 more constant. Yes, you can write, for first integration you can take the constant as c1, for second integration let's take it as c2, for third integration let's take the integral as, I mean constant of integration as c3. Now all together c1 plus c2 plus c3, I am taking it as what? C. That's why whenever you are integrating in a single step, if you are integrating twice or thrice or 4 times, whatever number of times you integrate in a single step, you write only one constant of integration, because addition or subtractions of all those constant is another constant. Right, so this is the second problem. Let's see a few more problems.
Okay, let's see the third one.
Let's say integration of root x plus 1 by root x whole square with respect to x. Now let's say we want to integrate this. Now what to do here? Is it not in the form of a plus b whole square? What is a plus b whole square? A square plus b square plus 2ab. Right, I am applying the a plus b whole square formula. A square plus b square plus 2ab. Now you see here, integration of square square root cancel. We get here x plus 1 square is 1. Square square root cancel. We get here again x plus root x cancel, 2 ones are 2, and here I write dx. Okay, so what is integration of x? Again apply that formula, integration of x raised to n dx. What is that? X raised to n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 plus constant of integration c. You apply that formula, here power is 1, so I write x raised to 1 plus 1 divided by 1 plus 1 plus integration of 1 by x log x. I have given the formula already, integration of 1 by x is log x. Now you can see here I am not writing separate integrals. Okay, you can just write it directly now. Okay, so integration of x raised to 1 is x raised to 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1 plus integration of 1 by x is log x plus integration of some constant. I told integration of k is nothing but what? Kx. Right, I have given this formula, integration of some constant k. So here 2 is a constant, so integration of 2 should be 2x. So plus some constant of integration c. Right, so now you simplify this, x raised to 1 plus 1 is 2. So x square by 2 plus log x plus 2x plus constant of integration c. Right, that's how we solve this problem. Right, okay, let's see the fourth problem then. Now let's say integration of, let's say, x square into 1 minus 1 by x square dx. Now how to solve this problem? First, what I will do is I'll multiply x square inside, x square into 1 x square minus x square into 1 by x square and x square cancel, we get what? 1. What I'm doing, I am multiplying x square inside, x square into 1 is x square. X square into 1 by x square cancel, we get 1. Now integration of x square, you apply the formula, integration of x raised to n dx is nothing but what? X raised to n plus 1 by n plus 1. I'll apply that formula. Right, so integration of x square is x raised to 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 minus, what is integration of 1? Integration of 1 is x. I have given the formula, integration of 1 is x plus some constant of integration c. Right, now equals to 2 plus 1 is 3, so x cube by 3 minus x plus constant of integration c. So that's the answer for this problem. Right, how we are done here? You multiply x square inside, then you integrate it separately. Right, now this is the fourth one, let's see one more. Let's see integration of x cube minus x square plus x minus 1 divided by x minus 1 dx. Now while looking at this question, you feel like it's so difficult because you have a cubic equation in the numerator and one more cubic equation in the denominator. So in this case, what we should do? See, in case of differentiation, if you are differentiating where you have, if you are differentiating such function, you could have applied what? the quotient rule. But here we don't have any quotient rule. So what we should do? So what I will do here is, first I'll try to simplify what the numerator. What I will do is, in the first two terms, what is common? In the first two terms, x square is common. So if I take x square common in the first two terms, I get x minus 1. So here x square into x is x cube, x square into 1 is x square. I am taking x square common in the first two terms. In the second two terms, I mean in the third and fourth term, do you have anything common? No. So it means I'll take 1 common. So inside we get x minus 1. 1 into x is x, 1 into 1 is 1. Whole divided by what? X minus 1 dx. Right. Now integration. In both of them I have x minus 1 common. I take x minus 1 common. So here I am left with x square plus here I am left with 1 divided by x minus 1 dx. Right. Now you can cancel x minus 1, x minus 1. And you get what? Integration of x square plus 1 dx. Now you see, I'll apply the formula integration of x raised to n. What is that? Integration of x square is what? Now from now onwards, you start writing directly. Okay. Integration of x square is x raised to 2 plus 1. 2 plus 1 is 3 divided by 2 plus 1. That is nothing but 3 plus integration of 1 x plus some constant of integration c. Right. So that's the solution for this problem. This is the fifth one. Okay. Let's see the next one. Let's see the sixth problem. Let's say you want to integrate 3x square plus x plus 1 divided by root x dx. Right. So in this case, what to do? You divide it separately. This means what? I want you to write 3x square by root x plus x by root x plus 1 by root x dx. I am dividing every term in the numerator by what? Root x. Now I'll just do one thing. I'll just take 3 outside here, or no problem. We can't take in outside because 3 is related to first term. What I will do here is 3 as it is, x square as it is, root x, I can write it as x raised to half. Okay, root is nothing but power half. So root x I can write x raised to half plus here x as it is, or x raised to 1 it is. Root x is again nothing but what? X raised to half. Now plus, here it is 1 by root x, I am keeping it as it is. Why I am keeping it as it is? I have already given the formula for integration of 1 by root x. In the previous video, I have given the formula for what? Integration of 1 by root x, 2 root x. Right. So no need to modify this. I'll just modify these two terms. Okay. So integration 3 as it is. Now you apply the formula a raised to m by a raised to n. A basic formula, a raised to m minus 1, m minus n, right, laws of indices. So you apply that, x raised to 2 by x raised to 1 by 2, 2 minus 1 by 2, 2 minus 1 by 2, plus x raised to 1 minus 1 by 2, plus this 1 by root x as it is, right, dx. Now this is integration of 3 as it is, x raised to. Take LCM, 2 2s are 4, 4 minus 1, 3, you get x raised to 3 by 2, plus 2 1s are 2, 2 minus 1, 1, you get x raised to 1 by 2, plus 1 by root x, and I write what? Dx. Now here you apply x raised to n formula, integration of x raised to n formula, you know, right? So this I write, see here. 3 as it is, integration of x raised to n is x raised to n plus 1. So 3 by 2 plus 1 divided by 3 by 2 plus 1, x raised to n plus 1 by n plus 1, plus here x raised to n plus 1, n is 1 by 2 here, so 1 by 2 plus 1 I mean x raised to 1 by 2 plus 1 divided by 1 by 2 plus 1 plus integration of 1 by root x is nothing but 2 root x, given the integration formula already, right? So now this is equals to 3 as it is, x raised to, take LCM, 2 ones are 2, 3 plus 2, 5, you get 5 by 2 divided by 5 by 2 plus x raised to, 2 ones are 2, 1 plus 2, 3, you get 3 by 2 divided by 3 by 2 plus 2 root x plus constant of integration c. Now this 2 goes up, right? 2 3s are 6 divided by 5, x raised to 5 by 2. 2 1s are 2, x raised to 3 by 2 divided by 3. This 2 goes up here, right? Now plus 2 root x plus constant of integration c. That's the solution for this problem, right? So here you in exam, okay, you need not write all the steps. Here I have written all the steps just for your understanding purpose. You can skip some of the steps, okay, whichever, for example, let's say from here to, you can write it here directly. In the exam, you can write this step directly. Okay, need not solve these two steps. But I want you to understand how you got those steps. Right, that's why I'm writing in detail. Right, okay, this is the sixth one. Let's say the seventh one. Let's see the seventh one. Now let's see few problems based on what? Based on trigonometry also, right? Now let's see, let's say we want to find integration of tan square x dx. In the formula, okay, I have given integration of tan x, but here we have integration of tan square x. Now how to find integration of tan square x? See, what I will do is integration, we know 1 plus tan square x is nothing but what? Sec square x. Right, now if you want tan square x, sec square x plus 1 that side minus 1. So you can write tan square x as sec square x minus 1. Why should I express like this? Because you know integration of sec square x. I have given the formula for integration of sec square x, right? So I express tan square x as what? Sec square x minus 1 with respect to x. Now you know integration of sec square x. Integration of sec square x is what? Tan x, right? Minus integration of 1 is what? X plus constant of integration c. So integration of tan square x. Tan square x, I am writing it as sec square x minus 1. I am using this trigonometric identity. Then integration of sec square x is tan x minus integration of 1 is what? X plus some constant of integration what? C. Now let's see the 8th problem. Integration of, let's say, sec x into sec x plus tan x dx. Now how to solve this problem? Equals to integration. First, what I will do is, I'll take this sec x inside, I multiply to both the terms, sec x into sec x, sec square x plus sec x into tan x, right? So I'm taking sec x inside, I'm multiplying. Now integration of sec square x is what? Tan x, I have given the formula already, plus integration of sec x into tan x is what? Sec x plus constant of integration c. Right, now let's see one more here. Let's see the 9th one. Let's say integration of, we'll take a similar problem, cosec x into cosec x minus cot x dx. Let's say we want to solve this problem. Now integration, multiply cosec x inside, cosec x into cosec x cos x square x minus cos x into cot x, right? I am integrating with respect to what? X. Now, integration of cos x square x, I give the formula minus cot x minus integration of cos x into cot x is nothing but minus cos x plus some constant of integration c. Now, equals to minus cot x minus into minus plus cos x plus constant of integration c, right? So these are few what trigonometric problems. Let's see few more. You can just pause the video and you can note down them. Okay, let's see few more problems based on trigonometry itself. So let's take the 10th one, integration of let's say sec square x by cos x square x dx. So how to solve this problem? See, integration of, can I write sec square x as 1 by cos square x, because 1 by cos is sec, divided by cos x square x we can write as 1 by sin square x, and I write here dx. Now see here, integration 1 by cos square as it is into, I just reciprocate it, I just take reciprocal of it, sin square x by 1 dx. Now sin square x by cos square x is nothing but tan square x we got. How we have integrated tan square x? Tan square x I can write as x square x minus 1 dx, because we know 1 plus tan square x is nothing but what? Sec square x plus 1 that side minus 1. So tan square x I can write as sec square x minus 1. Integration of sec square x tan x minus integration of 1 x plus some constant of integration c. Right, that's the solution for what? Integration of sec square x by cos x square x. Let's see one more. Let's say integration of 2 minus 3 sin x divided by let's take cos square x dx. Okay, let's see this problem. How to do this? Just separate, split here. I write 2 by cos square x minus 3 sin x by cos square x dx. Right, now this, can I write it as 2 sec square x, because 1 by cos is what? Sec. So 1 by cos is sec, we have 1 by cos square, that is nothing but sec square, minus 3, see, sin x divided by, I'll take 1 cos x here, here we have 2 cos x terms, I just take 1 cos x term, sin x by cos x, I write it tan x. And I am left with one more cos x term here, and 1 by cos x is nothing but sec x. See, I am taking 1 cos with sin, sin by cos is tan, and one more cos I am left, 1 by cos is sec. Now 2 as it is, integration of sec square x tan x, right, minus 3 as it is, integration of sec x into tan x, integration of sec x into tan x is nothing but what? Sec x. Plus some constant of integration c, right? So that's the solution for what? This problem. So how we have done? We have separated, okay, then we have applied the basic trigonometric formula, then we have integrated, right? Let's see one more problem based on this. Okay, so let's do one thing. Yeah, I will take cos 2x divided by cos x plus sin x dx. Let's say we want to solve this problem. Now, see, I have given the formula for cos 2x in the previous video. cos 2x, you can write it as cos square x minus sin square x, right, whole divided by cos x plus sin x, I write dx equals to, see here, is it not in the form a square minus b square? Now how can you write a square minus b square? A minus b into a plus b, right? So cos x minus sin x into cos x plus sin x, a minus b into a plus b, divided by what? Cos x plus sin x, cos x plus sin x, I write dx here. Cos x plus sin x, cos x plus sin x, cancel. We got integration of cos x minus sin x dx. We got integration of cos x minus sin x dx. Now integration of cos x is nothing but sin x minus integration of sin x. Integration of sin x is minus cos x plus constant of integration c. Sin x as it is, minus into minus plus cos x plus constant of integration c. Right. So these are the few basic problems based on integration. Okay. So in the next session, what we will do is we will start with the first method of integration. Okay. Whatever the method we have seen, the inspection method, that's a basic method. Okay. Now we'll start with the real methods of integration. In the next session, we'll start with integration by substitution method. Okay. Thank you.